Right, how are we doing, folks? This is a homebrew video. I don't get a lot of homebrew videos out anymore, but for the people that still watch them or still subscribe to me that used to watch my homebrew videos, this is a little tutorial. I try and make it as simple as possible on how to seal the threads and the O-ring sort of style on the King Keg, because they are prone to leaking all the time. I've got the chance to have the gauge on mine, which I bought on eBay, and it shows me what sort of pressure is inside the pressure barrel. So that is 100% recommended. In one of my videos, it does recommend in the description. I could do it in this video as well, of where to get one of these gauges. You have to drill a 10 mil hole into the thing with a drill, and then you place it. It's got a nut, comes with a nut and a washer and that. But today I'm going to show you how to seal this 100%, because these leak all the time. If they don't, you know, if you haven't got a pressure gauge on it, it's going to be bad, folks, because you are not going to know whether there's pressure in it until you start pouring your beer. And we don't want no pressure in these barrels, because that's when your beer will start going off. So this is how you do it. You buy yourself, I've got a 10 pack of 10 on Amazon of P.T.F.E tape. I've tried different ways. I've even tried clean film, putting clean film around the rim. That doesn't work. I've tried that twice on two different caps and screwed it down. That does not work. This is the only thing that works. I've always used this since 2013, late 2013, I think I'll use this, and it works. And it works, folks. And here it is here. And basically what you do, first, I've got my sugar here. I'm going to put the sugar in there. And then we're going to seal the threads. I'm going to try and I bought some more because I'm running low. Put it around the threads and slowly work your way up towards the rim. Hopefully it doesn't run out. When you do get to the top, slightly overlay it, overflap it, so part of it is it's hanging over the rim. Sometimes it doesn't come out 100% great. It's got to look like this ain't at the moment. It's got to keep going with it. What's going on here? Right. Try and do best you can. That's it. Sometimes it just takes a lot of practice, folks. And if it doesn't come out properly, it's a bit of a nightmare. There it is. And it's cheap buy. Yeah, I've got it for £2 odd on Amazon. And you get a pack of 10. Quite a few meters. So that'll do, folks. There. And there we have it. I don't know if that's coming up on film. I'm using the GoPro on my head at the moment. So there's the P.T.F.E tape. You can see it's around the top, around the rim. And now what we've got the cap here. I've greased the, this is a flat O-ring. They call it the O-ring because it's like an O. And this is a flat base one. The King Kegs regularly come with, they're rounded O-rings. But I managed to get hold of, on eBay, the flat ones, which I thought would help seal it a bit better. But to be quite honest, I haven't noticed any difference. So I still use the P.T.F.E tape. Then we screw that on, folks. You can feel it's tight, very tight. And tighten it hand tight, as much as your hands can go. Yeah, whew. There's no need to get tools on it or nothing like that. Hand tight is 100% fine. And because I've got the gauge on it as well, I can be able to see when the pressure starts building up inside. But there we go, folks. Hope that I'm going to cut this down, but hope that helps. That's the P.T.F.E tape. That is 100% P.T.F.E tape and 100% recommended, folks. Okay. Thanks for watching. And if you're a regular Explorer fan, remember, I upload an Exploring video every Friday at 10 a.m. See you soon, folks, and thanks very much.
I don't want them, I don't want any gas leaking. Now I've got to try and get this thing off. It's going to be a tough one. I have got
some top of the King Keg lip, and there was part of it that felt sort of bumpy, and I believe that was where the leaking was coming from, you see. So I basically started thinking again.